You are listening to the Rockstar Mentor Podcast, Fan Mail Friday edition, and this is episode 16. Let's rock and roll.
Welcome to the Rockstar Mentor Podcast, the podcast to inspire you and bring the kickstart you need to crush it in the art industry. So join Sonya each week to bring you the art of marketing your creative service or product. You've got questions, we've got answers. It's Fan Mail Friday, and we are here to answer questions to get your weekend started. Now, your creatively energetic host, Sonya Paz.
Happy Friday, everyone, and thank you so much for tuning in to our episode of Fan Mail Friday. And this is episode 16. This is one of my favorite times of the week that I can connect with you, answer questions that you have submitted via the website or maybe through one of the chats on Facebook. And this is exciting because I really love engaging with everyone, and I want you all to be able to flourish and excel in your creative service or your fine art or your jewelry or what have you. I got a great question today. Actually, this question came in about 10 days or so ago, and I'm just getting to this one. So I do apologize, Randall, for the delay in answering your question here online. And I want to start off by letting everyone know that Randall he's a collector, but he is also a videographer out of the Los Angeles area, and had asked me back in 2010, I believe, 2010 or 2011, he was going to be traveling up to San Francisco and wanted to stop in at the gallery and do some videotaping of me. Well, me being me and not feeling like I was truly prepared, I kind of rescheduled. So I feel bad about that. And we were going to try to connect again, but in 2012 when he was up again, but that didn't end up panning out. So he has recently seen me on video on Facebook doing the Facebook Live for Rockstar Mentor and for Sonya Paz Art and Design and for Vino Paint, which is my other business where I teach people how to paint while they drink and socialize with friends and create. So I have overcome my fear of being in front of the camera. Now, for those of you who know me pretty well, know that my father he's still alive, but he had a thriving wedding photography business back in the day. And when I was a young girl, I had always been the prop for him. Whenever he got a new lens or a new camera or a new filter, yeah, everyone, this is how photography used to be. This is not click and shoot and pop it in your iPhone and grab some filters and do some little photo magic. This is back in the day when you had to actually put filters on lenses and lenses on cameras and cameras on tripods and filtered lighting and umbrellas and reflectors and the whole gamut. And a lot of that technology is still used. However, you were not doing all of the magic in the dark room like you used to. Now, my father would always say, "Sonya, come out to the patio," and he'd have me sit. And I would sit there for the longest time while he adjusted the lighting and got the meter with the camera and got all the settings done. And I would be sitting there holding a rose or looking up at a tree or leaning against something. And I hated it. And I just grew to not be much of a fan of being in front of the camera. I prefer to be arty and get behind the camera. And that will be a whole nother podcast. But what I wanted to tell you was, with video, that was even more of a sore subject with me. I thought, I don't like the way I look on the camera. I don't want to be practicing. I stumble over my words. I don't feel like I'm acting natural. So with that said, here we are. Facebook, thank you. Thank you, Facebook, for finally allowing me to be completely me live on Facebook. I am surprised at myself on how much I actually enjoy it. I'm actually enjoying it. And I think because it's a one take Jake. It's one take. I know I have maybe 1 to 2 to 3 to 4 minutes to talk about what I'm promoting, discuss something that is on my mind. I even filmed, oh, this is a good one, on my personal Facebook page, and I did make this public. I filmed my dog in our pool and she swam. She went down the whole length of the pole, got out and jumped up on her lounge chair and sat there. I got over 33,000 views, everyone. I was stunned. Actually, I haven't looked at it in about a week at the stats, so I may even have more than 33,000, but that's like Facebook, YouTube stuff that I hear about but never happens to me. And I swear I'm going to start putting more of my dog into my promos and my Facebook and my promotions, because I think she's a rock star and she's just going to, maybe she'll help me leverage some things. So, hey, Facebook Live for artists. If you are an artist and you are want to get brave and you want to shine and you want to show people what you're working on, or talk a little about your process, show yourself painting. If you're at an art show, you're an exhibit, turn on Facebook Live. Make sure you do have a good connection, though, because it will cut you off and it will launch your video before you have a chance to sort of know what happened. But it is by far, to my surprise, not only fun, but Facebook is giving the videos a lot more attention than just the standard average post or the standard post with photos. Now, I'm not saying start filming yourself eating or showing off food. I'm saying if you are trying to get some attention as far as letting other people know about your work or projects that you're working on, try it out. Hey, if you don't like the way it turned out, you simply delete it. It's not going to be on there forever. Things, you can delete it. It's not a big deal. Just make sure that if you're going to be doing this, if you don't have a business page, you can do it off your personal page. If you have a business, do it off your business page and you have a little bit more features. Well, you have a lot more features. So not only can you edit the thumbnail, because of course the photo or the still that Facebook selects is always one of me with my eyes half open or my mouth is open and I'm not looking, I'm animated anyway. So it just is not the most flattering, but it will give you some options to select the thumbnail, or you can put a customized photo of yourself there instead. Now, this is something I want you to try and let me know what you think. In fact, if you're in the group, facebook.com/rockstarmentor, like that page and send me a link of where I can view it. I would love to see what kind of engagement you're getting. Would love to see your journey on doing the Facebook Live as well. And if you would like to share this, we have Art Maker Monday and we have Fan Mail Friday on the Mastermind page, which you can sign up through rockstarmentor.com under the Cool Tools area, or simply go to facebook.com/rockstarmentor. And that is our page where I'm going to be putting more videos up there, tidbits. I'm going to spin off some ideas and some extensions of the podcast and vice versa, announcing some new things, maybe some contests, some free airtime. If you want to talk to me and pick my brain for about 15 minutes, which is normally about, I think it's on the website now for about $48 right now, and it's going to go up to $68 after, well, I'm not sure when, but soon. And that is something that will be only offered to people who like the page or are on our mastermind group. So, Facebookers and artists and rock stars, I want you to go off and try something new. Jump off the cliff. Don't be afraid. Well, not a big cliff, but, you know, jump off the curb and try something new. Hey, if I can do it, you can do it. Trust me. I am not a fan of getting my videos out there and things like that. So, but I'm having a good time doing it. Haven't really grasped a hold of the other stuff like Snapchat or some of the other social networking things, but I am enjoying, I am mainly on Instagram and on Facebook. So that is a wrap for today, everyone. Hey, you can sign up online to be part of our newsletter and be on the front lines to receive VIP emails and specials. Be privy to some freebie tools, tips, and techniques that I have prepared just for you. And be part of our Fan Mail Friday with questions you might have. I would love to read your questions on the air. A lot of folks that have engaged with me are excited and give me big thumbs up on reading their questions to them on the air. So I want to definitely thank Randall from Los Angeles for reconnecting again and for sending this email to me And Randall, the next time you're up in the NorCal area, let me know. Maybe we'll definitely get something together as far as some video and some footage and something fun. I'm truly getting out of my shell. The podcast channel here has been fun and amazing. My quest to conquer 2016 out of fears and obstacles. Like I said, if I can do this stuff, everyone, then you can do this. You are all rock stars. I look forward to helping you out. I'm so glad you're tuning in. Have a great, great weekend, and peace out, everyone.